our channel Current Affairs for you. Let's begin the important current affairs of 18th January 2021. The first question for today is, who unveiled India's first indigenously designed and developed driverless metro car? Options are Amit Shah, Modi, Rajnath Singh, Dr. Harshvardhan. Option C is correct here. Defense Minister Rajnath Singh unveiled India's first ever indigenously made designed and developed driverless metro car by Rajnath Singh. So Amit Shah is the head of a committee to celebrate 125th birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Next, Modi ji recently inaugurated a railway station near the Statue of Unity, which is in Kevadia village, from Vadodara to Kevadia. So this railway track connects Vadodara to Kevadia. Next, Harshvardhan recently launched something called Sagar Anveshika. This is a coastal research vessel. Sagar Anveshika, launched by Dr. Harshvardhan. Next, Defense Minister Rajnath Singh. This car is manufactured at BEML, which is in Bangalore, Karnataka. Next question. Where did Dr. Harshvardhan inaugurate Doppler weather radars? Options are Mukteshwar, Uttarakhand, Kufri, Himachal Pradesh, Khandwa, Madhya Pradesh, Tapi, Gujarat, Nirmal, Telangana. So option A and B, both are correct here. So Dr. Harshvardhan inaugurated Doppler weather radars, DWR, Doppler weather radars, in Mukteshwar district, which is in Uttarakhand, and Kufri district, which is in Himachal Pradesh. In these two places, Dr. Harshvardhan inaugurated Doppler weather radars. Now, recent news about Khandwa, which is in Madhya Pradesh, there is a 600 megawatt solar energy power plant. This is world's largest floating 600 megawatt solar energy power plant at Omkareshwar Dam on Narmada River. See, four things important. World's largest floating park, which is in Khandwa, Madhya Pradesh, and having 600 megawatt solar power plant, at Omkareshwar Dam, on which river? On Narmada River. Next, Tapi, Gujarat. Let's talk about Tapi, Gujarat in recent news. World's biggest zinc smelter project. World's biggest zinc smelter project, which is in Tapi, Gujarat. Next, let's talk about Nirmal. First rescue and rehabilitation center for monkeys. First rescue and rehabilitation center for monkeys inaugurated in Nirmal, Telangana. Next, so who is Dr. Harshvardhan? He is Minister of Science and Technology, Earth Sciences, and Health and Family Welfare. Science and Technology, Earth Sciences, and Health and Family Welfare Minister is Dr. Harshvardhan. He inaugurated these two on the day of 146th Foundation Day of India, Indian Meteorological Department, which is in Delhi. So this is 15th January. Now, what is this radar helps us? This radar will provide information about cyclones, weather related issues, and storms. This will help people who related to agriculture, like farmers. And also, next question. Which of the following organization registered itself as a private company in Bengaluru, Karnataka? Options are SpaceX, Tesla, Google, none of the above. Option B is correct here, Tesla. Recently, the founder of Tesla, who is he? Elon Musk became the world's richest person. Now, Tesla is going to make a private company in Bengaluru, Karnataka. Let's talk about this. Next, where did Fiat Chrysler Tesla? Tesla is a automobile company which makes cars, and this is established in a research and development unit in Bengaluru, Karnataka. Next, where did Fiat Chrysler Automobiles and Wipro jointly set up a digital hub. Options are Krishna, Andhra Pradesh, Kullu, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarkashi, Uttarakhand, Hyderabad, Telangana, Kapurthala, Punjab. Option D is correct here. In Hyderabad, Telangana, Fiat Chrysler Automobiles and also Wipro jointly set up a digital hub in Hyderabad, which is in Telangana state. Now, Krishna, Andhra Pradesh. Krishna district stood first position in marine district category in fisheries sector by Government of India. Next, Kullu, Himachal Pradesh. Kullu and Shimla. In both these two, 210 megawatt Luhri stage one hydropower project solar has been inaugurated recently. So in Kullu and Shimla, 210 megawatt Luhri stage one hydropower project on Satluj River has been inaugurated recently. Next, Uttarkashi, Uttarakhand, Pirul power project has been inaugurated in Uttarkashi, Uttarakhand. Kapurthala, Punjab, Mega Food Park has been inaugurated at Kapurthala, Punjab. Next question. Which country recently withdrawn Open Sky Treaty? Options are Russia, China, Japan, USA. So, Russia becomes the second country to withdraw from Open Sky Treaty. And which is the first country? USA, United States of America, is the first country to withdraw Open Sky Treaty. Now, Russia recently withdrawn from Open Sky Treaty. So, Russia becomes the second country. Let's talk about China. China, five satellites it sent. China country sent five satellites with its new space carrier called Long March 8. So China country sent five satellites with its new space carrier called Long March 8. And also China sent something called Chang'e 5. And this satellite will carry or collect rock material from moon. Next, China launched something called Govt 14. This is an earth observation satellite. Next, let's talk about Japan. So Japan country, to reduce space debris, Japan planned to make wooden based satellite by 2023. Which country? Japan. Next question. Who has been appointed as the United Nations Human Rights Council as its president in 2021? Options are Vidisha Maitri, Najat Shamil Khan, Sangeeta Srivatsav, Varsha Joshi. Option B is correct here. Najat Shamil Khan has been appointed as United Nations Human Rights Council as its president in 2021. She belongs to Fiji country. And let's talk about the other options. Vidisha Maitri becomes United Nations Advisory Committee head on administration and budgetary questions. Sangeeta Srivatsav become the first chancellor for Allahabad University. Varsha Joshi become National Dairy Development Board chairman. Next question. Which of the following signed MOU with Idea Forge for procuring high altitude variant of Switch unmanned aerial vehicle is nothing but drone. Now, which of the following organization signed a memorandum of understanding with Idea Forge for procuring high altitude variant of unmanned aerial vehicle, UAV or drone? Options are DRDO, Indian Army, Indian Navy and Indian Air Force. So option B is correct here, Indian Army. So Indian Army signed MOU with Idea Force for procuring high altitude variant of unmanned aerial vehicle. So next, so they signed almost 20 million contract. Defense Research Development Organization, so the headquarters of Defense Research and Development Organization, it's in New Delhi, and the present chairman is Dr. Satish Reddy is the Defense Research and Development Organization chairman. So recently we celebrated Indian Army Day, which is 15th of January. Indian Navy Day, we celebrate 4th December. 4th December we celebrate Indian Navy Day. Indian Air Force Day we celebrate 8th of October. 8th of October. So Indian Navy Admiral is Karambir Singh. Indian Army Chief of Army Staff General Manoj Mukund Naravane. And Air Force Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria. Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria is the Air Chief Marshal present. Next, who has been conferred with Scotch Challenger Award? Options are K. Viramani, Carolina Arujo, Margaret Atwood, Arjun Munda. So Tribal Minister of India Arjun Munda recently conferred with Scotch Challenger Award for 2020. Next, K. Viramani won Dr. Narendra Dabolkar Award, Dr. Narendra Dabolkar Memorial Award for 2020. Carolina Arujo won Ramanujan Award for 2020. Margaret Atwood won Dighton Peace Award for 2020. Next question. Which bank has launched iDaylights New Year Bonanza? Options are ICICI, HDFC, Yes Bank, Bandhan Bank. So ICICI is the correct answer. ICICI recently launched something called iDaylights New Year Bonanza. Now recently about HDFC. HDFC Chairman Deepak Parekh. Yesterday also I told you Deepak Parekh is the chairman of HDFC. Yes Bank recently inaugurated wellness themed credit card, and the present CEO and MD for Yes Bank is Prashant Kumar. Prashant Kumar is the managing director or chief executive officer for Yes Bank. Bandhan Bank recently started a new account for military people called Bank Shaurya Salary Account. Last question for today. Who has been awarded with Chief of Army Staff Commendation for his outstanding contribution to armed forces during the pandemic? Options are Narendra Batra, Vidyut Mohan, Ratan Tata, Amresh Kumar, Sini Vishwanathan. So option D is correct here. Amresh Kumar has been conferred with Chief of Army Staff Commendation. Why? Because for his contribution to armed forces during this pandemic COVID-19 situation. Now, Narendra Batra won Capital National Foundation Award for 2020. Vidyut Mohan become Young Champion of the Year for 2020 by United Nations Environment Program. Ratan Tata recently won something called Global Visionary of Sustainable Business and Peace. Global Visionary of Sustainable Business and Peace. Sini Vishwanathan won Bharati Award for 2020. Bharati Award for 2020. So that's all for today's current affairs. Hope you guys like the video. Thank you for watching. Till then, share with your friends.